Hey everyone, welcome back. This is Dan from DHTV, and today I'm going to be showing you how to pair and set up your new Apple Watch Series 7 with your iPhone. Let's get started. All right, now you're going to need an iPhone 6S or later for this to work, and we've got the Apple Watch Series 7 right here. So the first thing we're going to do is actually power it on. So you're going to need to press and hold that side button right here, and you'll see the Apple logo appear. Once the Apple logo appears on screen, just give it a few seconds. It may take about 30 seconds to a minute to power on. And when you see this screen, your Apple Watch is now powered on. So what it's asking us to do is bring our iPhone close to our Apple Watch. You want to make sure that you have Bluetooth enabled here, which we do. So I'm just going to lock my phone, unlock it quickly, and bring it close to my Apple Watch here. And just give it a quick second here to connect up. You'll see this appear on screen here. So it'll say, use your phone to set up this Apple Watch. We'll tap continue. And now we can choose to set it up for ourselves or to set it up for a family member. So for us, we're gonna set this up for ourselves. And when you do that, you'll see a little square appear. Basically, what we're gonna do is hold our camera over the Apple Watch and try to catch that in frame. So it's a little bit difficult to show it on camera. I'll do my best. And there you go. So now your Apple Watch is paired with the iPhone. So what you want to do at this point is to choose if you want to restore from a backup. So if you had a previous backup, you can tap that or set it up as a new Apple Watch, which is what we're going to do in this video. So now it's just going to connect for our Apple Watch, and this might take a little bit of time. So you don't want to power down your iPhone or your Apple Watch at this time. Just be patient and let it do its thing. Once you see the terms and conditions, you want to just kind of go through them and tap agree at the bottom right. It's going to sign into your account. Again, at this time, just let it do its thing and don't power anything down. All right, now once it's complete, you'll get this page on your iPhone, and it's just going to ask you to enable route tracking. So this is a personal preference if you'd like that. And what it's going to do is use your location for Apple Watch workouts and track routes, local weather for outdoor workouts, etc. So you can choose to enable that or not. I'll disable it for now. You have watch analytics, which again, you can choose to share with Apple or not. I don't share them with Apple. And then you'll see shared settings, and it says that Apple Watch shares settings with iPhone for location services, Find My, and all that stuff. So we'll just tap OK there. And now we can customize our Apple Watch for our personal preference here, and mainly the text. So you can choose the text size, and you can see on the Apple Watch here, it's going to increase or decrease depending on where you want it and where you're comfortable and how much you want to see on your screen. You can also bold the text right there if you prefer that as well. We're just going to leave it there for now. It's a good size for me. You can also choose to set it up later in the Apple Watch app. And you can do this with all of these settings. So don't worry if you choose something now that you want to change later. You can always change it up. This page here, we can create a passcode for our Apple Watch. I don't traditionally do this, but I'll show you just because we're here now. You can create a passcode or you can add a long passcode. So if you tap create a passcode, it's going to give you 4 digits that you'll choose on your Apple Watch. If you choose add a long passcode, it's going to give you the ability to choose a passcode that's more than 4 digits, and you can see the stipulation with that as well. So we're just going to go back. I'll just create a passcode to make things simple here so you can see what it'll do when you have one. I'm just going to make it very basic. It's saying it's too easy. If you ever get that, try to change your passcode, but we're just going to use this anyway just for this example. We'll enter it in again. Now you can see that we have automatic updates, or we can choose to set them up manually. So if you prefer to install your updates manually, you can tap there or just tap continue. Here you can set up Apple Pay. We'll leave this alone. You can set this up later in the Watch app just because there's a lot of personal information with this. You can't access that. So tap set up later. Emergency SOS. So this is just telling you that if you press and hold on the side button on your Apple Watch, that's this button right here, it's going to enable the emergency SOS service. And what this does is also send a message to your emergency contact. So if you have that all set up on your iPhone, it'll work with that as well. Also, fall detection can call emergency services. So if you actually fall with this on, it'll actually enable the emergency SOS and then call emergency services. And this is a great thing. You can see right here a little bit more information about that as well. So we'll tap continue. And now it's letting us know about the new always on display, which is a nice feature. So we'll tap continue there as well, meaning that the display will always be on. Now, this page is a personal preference as well. So basically what it's going to do here is try to install any applications you have on your iPhone on the Apple Watch if there is a watch application available to it. If you choose that, it'll take a while to run those installations. So for this, I'm just going to choose later. Now you can see the different views that you have. So traditionally, this is how our Apple Watch has been looking. Most people use that look, but if you prefer the list view, you'll see right here, it'll look like that, and you'll kind of use the crown or just swipes up and down to find all of your different applications. But just for this example, we'll use grid view, and once again, you can change this in the Apple Watch settings on your iPhone. So at this time, it's going to go through a syncing process. I'll speed things up again so you don't have to watch the whole thing. But while it's doing this, don't power off the devices, leave them on. This might take quite a bit of time, especially if you have it installing the other applications as well. Now, just in the middle of the update, this popped up here, and it's just letting you know that your Apple ID and phone numbers are now being used for iMessage and FaceTime on a new Apple Watch. So you'll just tap OK at this point. And again, just let it continue to do its thing. All right, and once it's set up, you'll hear a little chime. You'll see your Apple Watch sort of turn on, and you'll see your watch face right there. You have a little welcome to the Apple Watch page here, and we'll tap OK there. And this is the Apple Watch application where you can access your settings and features for your Apple Watch on your iPhone. Now, if you don't see that right there, it should be on your home screen. It's the Watch app. You can also search for it in your app library. Now, within the Apple Watch application here, this is where you can customize all the settings. So you can see your app view here if you wanted to switch it over to the list. So now when you go to your apps, they look like this. They're in a list view. This is why I don't really like the passcode. It just makes things so much slower. And then you can just use the digital crown to sort of scroll through everything. Or you can just swipe with your finger. It's a personal preference if you prefer grid or list. You also have your display and brightness here. So if you need to change anything here, wake on wrist, wake duration. You have your face gallery here, which will allow you to change all the watch faces. So you have a whole bunch that you can choose from here. And they're customizable as well. So each one that you tap on, you can see you can change colors. There's a whole bunch of variations. And you can really customize the Apple Watch experience for yourself. But I'll be putting together a full tips and tricks video to help you get some of the better features enabled on this Apple Watch. There's that emergency SOS that you want to kind of work with here. If you want fall detection on, you want to hold the side button to dial. There's a whole bunch of stuff in here that you'll want to play with and customize for yourself. And I always tell everyone to go through the privacy settings just to make sure there isn't anything using any of your information that you would prefer it not to be using. If it's tracking fitness, your respiratory rate, all of that stuff. And then if you chose not to set up your updates automatically, you'll go to General and you'll see software update here. You'll tap there and you'll see that there is an update for me because I have them set up to download automatically. You can then choose to download it. Now, if you chose to set them up so that they do download automatically, it's going to download them for you and then prompt you to install it. So you'll choose when you feel the most comfortable to install. Usually I do it at night, or if I'm making a video, it'll be on video, but you can see we're getting watchOS 8.0.1 and it's got 3 minutes remaining here. And then I'll be able to install that. So there's a whole bunch that there is to this Apple Watch. So definitely stay tuned to the channel. There's a whole bunch of videos coming up on the Apple Watch. If you have any questions regarding the setup process or if you have a request for a video, let me know in the comments below. I'm happy to go through that and help you out. And as always, don't forget to hit that like button, subscribe to the channel, and click the bell notification box to be notified when I post new videos. And I'll see you in the next one.